Well, good afternoon and welcome to all that gather here today to witness this historic groundbreaking ceremony for the Corps Leadership and Military Science Building. Before I continue with my remarks, I just want to congratulate all those people that you see here on the shovels. They came out earlier and had already kind of done this work that you see behind me here. So let's give them a round of applause for all the pre-work that they did. Well, this building demonstrates the commitment of the university to the growth of the Corps of Cadets and the importance of this program to the country, the Commonwealth, and this university. As you know, we intended our building to be more than just a gathering of office spaces and classrooms for the Corps and ROTC programs. It needed to be an extension of the storytelling that began with Lane Hall, Barracks Number 1, as well as Pearson Hall East and West, and the upper quad as a whole. That is why you will see the level of detail going into every square inch of the building. Everywhere you look, there will be a reminder of what the Corps has stood for since it began in 1872. Its soaring atrium will cause all that enter to look up, seeing that not even the sky is the limit to what our graduates will accomplish in the decades ahead. We have specific spaces dedicated to integrated security that will support education and preparation for our cadets for the world that they will graduate into, whether they serve in the public and private sector or the United States military. And as much as we are thinking about the future, we are also honoring the past. That's why a crucial and exciting part of the facility will include the Corps Museum that will allow our alumni, future cadets, and soon-to-be graduates to be inspired by the historical legacy left by those who have come before. We're grateful today to have with us representatives from many elements of the university who have brought us to this point, including the Board of Visitors, staff, and alumni, and the Corps itself. It's now my privilege to welcome to the podium and to today's ceremony, University President Tim Sands.
Thank you very much, General Fullhart. I'm honored to be part of today's groundbreaking. It's an important milestone for the Corps of Cadets and for Virginia Tech. I often talk about how much I enjoy seeing the Corps on the drill field in pass and review, practicing. Unfortunately, this past year, the Corps was there, but the rest of our students weren't. So we're really excited about the fall and getting that symbolism of the Corps back on the drill field where everyone can see, reminding us of our incredible history at Virginia Tech and the way that the Corps connects our past to the future. The Corps Leadership and Military Science Building will provide, as you've heard, new learning and gathering space that will enhance the experience at Virginia Tech. The new building will also support our plan to grow the Corps Cadets from about 1,100, a little over 1,100 to 1,400 cadets over the next couple of years. And it also supports the broader vision for our land-grant university. Our ongoing investment in the upper quad demonstrates the importance of the Corps Cadets and the leadership experiences it provides. And I've really enjoyed watching the growth and development over the past few years. It'll be exciting to have this space completed and to have it come together, to have the upper quad in a state where I don't think Randy would ever say that it's done, but having this building finished will be a mark or milestone in the development of the Corps, but also of Virginia Tech. I think it'll be a real highlight in our history as we look back. Well, there have been a lot of people who've been led us up to the position we're in right now. We're about to celebrate the groundbreaking, and we look forward to being here in, I don't know, 2 years or less to celebrate with a ribbon cutting. It now gives me great pleasure to turn the microphone over to one of our great Corps alums and a fantastic Hokie and a friend, Jay Pearson.
Thank you, Tim. On behalf of all of our alumni, I want to welcome you and thank you for making this building happen. In the mid-1990s, our Corps almost got shut down due to lack of interest. Now, with the support of the alumni, President Sands, and your team, we're heading to 1,400 cadets. Can you believe it, huh? This new building right here, and I'm looking at these two officers sitting here dressed all nice. We want your federal dollars coming right here, okay? With those new scholarships, this building's going to help you be more successful than ever before. And we want to make Virginia Tech the producer of leaders of great character. When this incredible space is finished, I know all alumni will be proud to see our shared history in the museum, and I hope they want to visit many, many times. Thank all of you for coming, and go Hokies. We did it!
Yeah. Now, Chuck Rao, please join us, President of the Heidi Tidies.
Thank you, General. Good afternoon. How's everybody doing today? As President of the Heidi Tidy Alumni Incorporated and as co-chair of the Commandant's Advisory Group, I'm very pleased to be part of today's groundbreaking ceremony. You know, as I think about it, with this building underway now, it reminds us ever more how much we need to focus on the naming opportunities in this building, different rooms and parts of the building that still are unfunded, as well as the fact that as we grow towards 1,400 cadets on campus in these residence halls, we need to continue to raise money for scholarships for these cadets. So thank you for allowing me to be part of this. With the core growth quickly approaching this 1,400 number, we're very excited about the future. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, Chuck, and thank all of you for being here today. So we are about to do what we have been now waiting on for many, many years, and that's to literally turn some dirt and start this process off.
Okay, let's bring it forward. And push. Look up and smile. And let's turn it. All right.
Right.
The new Military Science Building will help the Corps grow and prosper for years and years.
I want to thank Randy for all his hard work on this. This simply wouldn't happen without General Fullhart and his efforts. And to the alumni and the friends who have contributed to this, grateful for all that you have done for Virginia Tech and continue to do for Virginia Tech. You know, as an administrator and somebody that's been back in Blacksburg for 5 years, the Corps is extremely important to me personally. My father, class of 52, was in the Heidi Tidies. I grew up going to the annual VPI-VMI football game in Roanoke, Victory Stadium. I can remember the Corps marching in, the bands playing, quite emotional. And then growing up in this area and being brought to football games and coming for homecoming and being part of a Corps reunion and watching the band play and the Corps review and the homecoming parade and all that the Corps means to this institution, going to a football game and being able to sit there as you watch the Corps march into Lane Stadium as they still do today. It's a critical, critical part of not only our past, but our future. And to believe today that we're approaching 1,400 undergraduates in the Corps and it's growing and we're adding new buildings and you're investing in this program. This is Virginia Tech. This is what Tech means. It's important to us. It's important that we protect this tradition, that we grow this tradition, not only for Virginia Tech, but for this country. So I am very, very grateful to General Fullhart, to the alumni who have contributed to this, and to all the undergrads who are making the Corps a part of their future. God bless you, and thank you very much for all that you do for this institution. Go Hokies!